I'm leaving Pathankot by 8:30 morning. Yes, I know it's pretty late. क्योंकि मुझे लगा कि पठानकोट में गर्मी थोड़ा कम होगा, but it's hotter than I thought.
तो साला ये दुख का खत्म नहीं होता बे।
Today we are gonna reach Srinagar. So now the question is, Srinagar से पहले आता है उधमपुर, और उधमपुर जाने के दो routes हैं, जम्मू उधमपुर road and the Dhar road. The उधमपुर bypass Dhar road is in bad condition. But it's a shortcut, and the Jammu Udhampur road means you have to deal with the Jammu traffic. And I choose to go through Dhar road
Malik.
Because I am little bit late from my time, and I heard that the Dhar road includes some scenic views. I want to take a picture of this. So now officially I entered Jammu and Kashmir.
A few inches later.
Yeah, I had to get a new SIM card. Getting a new SIM card in Jammu and Kashmir is required for security reasons and local regulations. It helps authorities to monitor and regulate mobile communications in the region effectively. But if you have a postpaid SIM card, then it's okay. Finally, the mountains has been started. Why I choose Srinagar Leh Highway? The Srinagar Leh Highway for a solo Ladakh bike trip, as it offers gradual altitude gain, slow acclimatization and mind-blowing scenic beauty. And the Leh Manali Highway has rapid altitude changes. To avoid the risk of altitude sickness and more safer and enjoyable option, I go through Srinagar Leh Highway. I forgot to turn on the camera while entering into the tunnel. By the way, this is the Shyamaprasad Mukherjee Tunnel, also known as Chenani Nasri Tunnel. It is located in the lower Himalayas on the National Highway 44. It is India's longest road tunnel with a length of 9.28 km and the country's first tunnel with a fully integrated tunnel control system. It reduces the distance between Jammu and Srinagar by 30 km and travel time by 2 hours. Can you see a river on my left hand side? This is called the Chenab River. Chenab River also known as Chadarbaga. And I might have to face the rain. Luckily I haven't faced any rain issues until now. Ramban is a town in Ramban district of Jammu and Kashmir, which is the district headquarters of Ramban district. The road between Ramban to Banihal is rough, but the best mantra for this is not to stop and not to rush. As you watch the road, keep an eye towards the mountain as well. Check for any signs of rock shooting or landslide. The road are broken and dusty until I reach the Kashmir Valley. But when I reach, everything seems worth it. Once the 40 to 45 kilometer stretch of bad roads are covered, the rest of the roads from Banihal to Srinagar are smooth like a butter. Banihal has always been known as the gateway connecting Jammu and Srinagar. Do you know Kazigund Road Tunnel built at cost of over 3100 crore? It is a twin tube tunnel, one for each direction of travel. With the twin tubes being interconnected by a cross passage every 500 meter. Banihal Kazigund Road Tunnel is a road tunnel at elevation of 5870 feet above sea level in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. It is also one of the longest tunnel in India with a length of 8.45 km. In this tunnel, the speed limit is 50 km/h, and there are a total of 124 cameras ensuring safety and security throughout the passage. After exiting from the tunnel, I wondered where did those mountains vanish. Observing the mountains behind me, it seems they were fading away. However, I was wrong. It was the moment when Srinagar was only 69 kilometers away. That's when I noticed snow-capped mountains on my left, giving me goosebumps. It was my first close encounter with such a scenery. It was the first time I had seen such a close-up views of snow-covered peaks. Inspired by the breathtaking scene, I decided to take a break, enjoy a cup of tea, and cherish with the beauty of around me. After an hour, I resumed my journey towards Srinagar. Eager not to be late for my visit to Dal Lake. I have been excited about visiting Dal Lake for a long time. Srinagar, the largest city and the summer capital of Jammu and Kashmir, is known to be heaven on earth. Now, that name isn't given for nothing. No amount of words and pictures can do justice to its regal beauty. One must visit place to experience the wonder.